flattered by watching this short clip, which was taken from the Passion of the Christ movie. Pa-enable po ng sound.
Mashiach ka! Ana, amal, yelutku min tzalpa, tinakatse wa nehahami.
Amen. If you would remember those four last words were preached by Brother Otto, Pastor Al, Pastora Ami, and Pastor John. And now you're about to watch the fifth word, which is our topic for today. Amen. Let's all bow down our heads and pray. Heavenly Father, we praise and glorify you. We humbly come before you with hearts that are willing to be searched and willing to be opened by you this morning, willing to be searched, that we may ask you to purify if it's uncleaned, and willing to be opened, that we may ask you to soften or break it if it's hardened. Lord, let your glory fill this place, that your revelation will reach to the hearts of your people this morning, inside the church and who are watching us online right now, that your message today will create a significant impact on their lives, and the good news will pass from one soul to another for your glory, Father. And Lord, let no work of the enemy shall prosper throughout the delivery of your word, and we rebuke it in the most powerful name of our Lord Jesus Christ, and we entrust you everything today, O Father, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, our God, our Savior, and our Redeemer. Amen and amen. And the title of the topic, of our topic for today is, I Thirst, hindi masyadong kita yata, I Thirst, A Cry of Agony, Fulfillment, found in the book of John 19, chapter 19, verse 28 to 29, and let me read it once again for you. After this, know that you only have few hours to live. Who do you think you want to talk to? Who do you think you want to talk to? And what are the things that you're gonna say? Our loved ones who have passed away, maybe not all, maybe some of them or few of them, have left or uttered some important or memorable words before they said their final goodbyes. Hindi po ba? Those words, we really cherish them, and we keep reminiscing them because they mean a lot to us, right? And some are inheritance or pamana, some are promises or expressions of love, some are will, or what we call in Tagalog, habilin. You know, those words really penetrate our hearts when we think of them. And just like this son who literally tattooed his mom's last letter to him before she passed away. Nakita niyo ba ito sa Facebook? Diba? And I know that he did it for the same reason, to cherish his mom's last words before she said her final goodbye. And we were already told from the last four words preaching how our Lord Jesus Christ suffered, how he was mocked, how he was tortured, and despite he was sinless. And being the Son of God, he experienced the worst of the worst sufferings one could ever have. Our Lord Jesus Christ, during the approximately 6 hours hanging on the cross, he spoke his seven final statements, and those were spoken and addressed to the people whom he loved. When I said whom he loved, kasama po tayo doon, hindi po ba? And those words are for us. And those words give hope, those words give encouragement and direction. Now, one might get curious about the fifth word that we're studying today, and which is the phrase I thirst, which is not only the shortest among the seven, but also, when someone reads it in a very light understanding, he or she might think that this is not as important as the seven last words, as the six last words, rather. I thirst in Greek is one word called cry of physical pain. The cry reveals us five revelations. And though someone might think that this is just an ordinary cry, like what we mentioned earlier, all of the seven words were said for a purpose. And all of the revelations about this fifth word, mga kapatid, that we're going to discuss today will let us know about Jesus' sufferings, His humanity, the prophecies foretold about Him, and the Bible books correlate to each other despite of being written several centuries apart, and how this very word gives an assurance of redemption. Are you ready, mga kapatid? Amen. So today we're going to discuss five revelations about the four about the words. First would be, Jesus showed His humanity. We hear this fact a lot of times, mga kapatid, right? That Jesus, the Son of God, is 100% God and 100% man. And the Bible tells us in John 1:14, Jesus Christ, who is referred to as the Word, became a human being, kagaya po natin, and nakiisa sa atin, hindi po ba? What does it emphasize, mga kapatid? This simply emphasizes that Jesus, who is fully divine, took on human form and entered into the world to reveal God's glory, grace, and truth. Now, how do we relate it, mga kapatid, to our fifth word, I thirst? Our Lord Jesus Christ expressed His human need for water by saying those words. And it simply highlights the genuine humanity of Jesus as He experienced physical pain, exhaustion, and thirst like any other human being. Yes, siya po ay nag-perform ng number of miracles, di po ba? Which were witnessed by many. But alam din po natin na namuhay ang ating Panginoong Jesus bilang isang tao. He walked with man. Man saw Him face to face. His blood shed on the cross and more. Why does it matter? Why does it matter, mga kapatid, for us to know that Jesus, who is 100% God, live here on earth as 100% human? Dito sa ating mundong ginagalawan. Tingin nyo kaya, bakit? Why? Because whatever pain and sufferings you are experiencing right now, our Lord experienced them firsthand. And take note, they are way far from what you are dealing right now. It is way far from what you are dealing right now. And He took off His godly form and took on His human form to demonstrate His love para ipakita ang Kanyang dakilang pagmamahal sa atin upang tuparin ang Kanyang misyon. And that is to redeem us from the danger of eternal death. Ganyan po tayo kamahal ng ating Panginoong Jesus, kapatid. Even if it causes life and to experience incredible sufferings, which brings us to our next topic. Jesus cried of His physical sufferings. Who among you are active physically? Oh. Okay. Yung bang ilang kilometro yung tinakbo mo continuous without having a rest and not drinking even a single drop of water in between? Di ba ang hirap? When you reach up to a point when you can't breathe anymore, the only thing that you can do or that can give you comfort is to stop, rest, and drink water. In Arabic, shrabmai. Okay, and drink water. Being God in human form, like what we mentioned earlier, ang ating Panginoong Jesus ay naranasan muna ang lahat ng sakit, physically and emotionally, when he was on earth, and during his final hours before his death on the cross, is a great example of those sufferings, mga kapatid. And he was mocked, they spitted on him, they scourged him, hinagupit siya ng mga Roman soldiers, pinagdala siya ng cross na pagkabigat-bigat habang siya ay duguan. Nakita niyo naman po kanina, it's just a glance of what happened. May koronang tinik sa kanyang ulo, wearing a crown of thorns on his head while carrying his own cross. He was pierced with very big nails, and the list goes on and on and on. And this is the moment when he cried out, "I thirst." That reminds us of the incredible suffering that he suffered on our behalf. Take note, on our behalf. And he was not pretending to be thirsty. He's not pretending to be thirsty. Kasi nga sabi natin kanina, he's 100% human. And he was really feeling it kasi nga 100% human siya. Now, we might think that this is just a phrase, an expression of agony, tiredness. What else? I thirst. What else I thirst can mean? And this brings us to the third truth or revelations, which is Jesus fulfilled John, na sumulat po ng book of John itself, links Jesus' statement, "I thirst," to the fulfillment of Scripture. And that's what he said in our verse for today. In John chapter 19, verse 28, and John said, after this, highlighted ng ating Panginoong Jesus ay nalalaman ang lahat ng nangyayari. That our Lord was fully aware of what's been happening. That all happened according to complete His mission, mga kapatid. And His willingness to endure physical suffering as part of His redemptive purpose. According to Bible scholars, they were in fact at least 20 Old Testament prophecies na in the New Testament that happened during the crucifixion ng ating Panginoon. You can also scan the QR code so that it can take you to the website to that Jesus is fulfilling the prophecy in John chapter 19, verse 28. That very moment, He is showing us that everything was happening according to God's plan. So what were the prophecies fulfilled during that moment? Well, first, the phrase, "I thirst," at first read, we wouldn't probably think that it's a fulfillment of a prophecy. Because maaring i-relate lang natin to sa kalagayan ng ating Panginoon physically at that moment, during that time. But no. Like what we mentioned earlier, everything was happening according to God's plan. And there are two verses in the book of Psalm that were fulfilled. And first is the Psalm 22. Is, ano yung fourth word natin? If you may recall. Fourth word. Tingin ang notes. Spinrich po ni Pastor John. My God, why have you forsaken me? Which was preached by Pastor John last week. It's also a fulfillment of a prophecy in the same chapter of Psalm. In the same chapter of Psalm, it's the first verse. my God, why have you forsaken me? And if you will read the full chapter, it is actually telling the mostly happened to our Lord Jesus Christ that day. The dividing of his garments, the mocking. So in this verse, the psalmist experienced suffering where he reached to a point that his strength was dried up. And the line where it says, my tongue sticks to my jaws, highlighting that the psalmist was experiencing an unquenchable thirst. And here, mga kapatid, Christ fulfills the scripture by being the one who's suffering everything that was mentioned in that verse. Strength, drying up, tongue is sticking to his jaws, and really was laid in the dust of death. The second prophecy in the same book of Psalm 69, verse 21, and it says, says, mga kapatid, the psalmist described himself experiencing an unquenchable thirst. And instead of, nakita nyo kanina, instead of giving him a fresh water to drink, they gave him a sour wine to drink. Sa ibang salin, it's a vinegar. So, isipin natin, ano yung ginagawa ng wine doon, di ba? May ibang discussion doon. It's another interesting topic to discuss. So, yun yung ibinigay sa kanya. A very sour wine to drink. And hindi lang basta ibinigay, itinusok sa sponge, and you will get surprised, what is the purpose? Where do they use that sponge? Basahin nyo, where do they use that sponge? Doon ka talaga maiiyak kung paano nila inilipusta ang ating Panginoon. So, in the first three verses of Psalm 69, the psalmist described So, the psalmist described himself as someone na humihingi ng tulong sa Diyos dahil siya ay kasalukuyang nalulubog sa malalim na tubig. But ironically, he said in verse 3, sabi niya dyan, that his throat is parched or very, very thirsty. Our Lord Jesus Christ, mga kapatid, fulfills the prophecy in Psalm by experiencing yung pagkalunod niya sa deep waters of God's wrath. Not literally, but pagkalunod sa God's wrath. But he was thirsty. And then when he asked for something to drink to quench his thirst, yun nga, he was given a sour wine to drink. And it says in John 19, verse so the same thing happened, mga kapatid, sa ating Panginoong Jesus. And this is a great reminder. This is a great reminder that He is the one who fulfilled the Scripture. He is the suffering servant. He is the Lamb of God. He is the one who takes away of the sins of the world. And even to the finest detail where He said, I thirst. So let us be encouraged, mga kapatid, that we have a victory to the God we worship, who makes promises, who fulfills them all the way to the finest detail. Number four, Jesus showed us none of us have reached or will be reaching God's standard of being righteous. Wala ni isa man sa atin. Wala kahit pastor, kahit sino pa man yan. Sabi nga, naririnig ko, wala ni isa kalingkingan. And Romans 6.23, ano yung sabi sa Romans 6.23? Dapat kakambal yun ng Romans 3.23 eh. Romans 6.23, ano po yung sabi? For the wages of sin is death and falls short. It's referring to here is a place, yung sabi niya dyan, death. Apostle Paul is referring to a place of torment where the wage, where thirst is unquenchable. Kapatid, we were all bound to hell. And the Bible describes it in Matthew chapter 13, verse 42. Diba? Ang init nun? Tagang kulong na kulong sa apoy. And in that place, fiery furnace, and in that place, mga kapatid, there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. In Mark 9:48, hell is described as a place where worms do not die and the fire is not quenched. So the parable of the rich man and Lazarus gives us a clear picture of what the hell is, mga kapatid, which can be read in Luke chapter 16, verse 22 to 24. When Lazarus and the rich man both died, Lazarus was carried to Abraham's side, and the rich man was carried to Hades, where he saw Abraham far off with Lazarus at his side. Ano yung sinabi niya kay Abraham? What did he say to Abraham? In Luke chapter 16, verse 24, ganong kauhaw yung nararanasan ng rich man doon, mga kapatid. He was begging Abraham to tell Lazarus that even the tip of his finger, idip lang niya sa water para lang makatikim ng tubig yung uhaw na uhaw niyang dila. Mga kapatid, this is just a rough description. Or should I say, mababaw lang na paglalarawan sa dapat nating kalalagyan bilang mga makasalanan. We still don't know how worst the hell is. May nakarating na po ba dito? Walang pupunta doon. When our Lord was hanging and suffering on the cross, mga kapatid, and when He spoke the words, "I thirst," He was showing us a physical representation of eternal condemnation. Jesus Christ endured the thirst of death and thirst of hell, so we will never experience it. He did it all for us. That is why the next word He uttered was also a very important one. When He said, "It's finished." I-discuss po natin yan next. Matthew Henry, a known Bible commentator, said this, "The torment And he only sees the righteousness of Jesus Christ covering us. And we are all drinking the living water, which brings us to our fifth and final point, which is so to understand this better, mga kapatid, we should go back to the creation of when God created Adam and Eve. Balik tayo sa Genesis. In a perfect garden where everything they need for life was provided. Food, masasarap na pagkain, unlimited, and the enjoyment of God's presence, including the great rivers of the east, which can be read in Genesis chapter 2, verse 10. Experience all of the effects of their sin, including hunger, death, pain, sorrow, sickness, and thirst. So we can say that being thirsty is one of the curses they receive from God. In Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 48, sabi po dyan, God warns. But there was hope. Water in a dry place. When the suffering servant comes, the invitation of Isaiah 55:1 is given. Sabi po dyan, come, everyone who thirsts, come to the waters. And for those who come, God promises in Isaiah 58:11 this, shall be. Our living water. Sabi po sa John 4:13, 4. Thirst by receiving the wrath of God against our sins. And though he dies, he rises from the dead, ascends to the right hand of the Father, and gives eternal life to everyone who repents of their sins and places their faith in Him and His work on the cross. Napaka-importante. Dapat we place our faith on Jesus Christ's work on the cross. In Him, we have our spiritual thirst for reconciliation with God quenched for all eternity. And that's the spring of what? That's the spring of water welling up to eternal life. And Jesus provided for our thirst. Amen? May I invite everyone to please stand up? Thirsty. And that is because we are still living on our flesh. We are still subject to experiencing trials, disappointments, challenges. Kapatid, you might be in a situation right now where it feels like God is too far away from you. Yun bang parang lahat na lang ng hindi magaganda nangyayari sa'yo, nararanasan mo. Kapatid, let me tell you that all of those sufferings have been experienced by our Lord Jesus Christ. And He won it all for us. When He spoke the words, "I thirst," He also expressed that we will never feel thirsty again. We will never feel thirsty anymore if we accept Him into our lives. Kagaya nung sinabi niya doon sa babaeng Samaritana. I encourage you all to celebrate and delight in this truth with me today and press on toward that day when we enter our eternal home and enjoy dwelling with Him as our springs of living water. Let us pray. Let's bow down our heads and pray. Lord, we want to thank You for bringing us again back to that moment when You suffered at the cross of Calvary. That gives us a great reminder, Panginoon, of how deep, how long, how unconditional Your love is for us. The sufferings that made a way for us to experience the living water that You promise in Your word. I pray, O God, that whatever we've heard today will manifest in our lives and Your glory, Your works in us, will be evident to the people around us, that will give them reasons to know You more and experience the same living water that we enjoy. I pray, Lord, for my brethren who are with us today and watching us online right now to keep pressing and keep holding to Your promises that one day we will be together with our only Savior and be reminded that whatever we are experiencing right now, You know all of it. Hindi po lingid sa'yo lahat ito, Panginoon. You know all of it and we have nothing to worry about. And all we need is to love, trust, and worship You, Panginoon. In Jesus' name we pray, amen and amen. God bless us all po.